11, 11. So it
Okay.
is 11, 11. Yeah. So we cannot make it as 5.5. So I'll make it as 6 programs for your first lab internals. That's fine. Any doubts? Any doubts about
Yes,
that?
ma'am.
No, ma'am. Yeah. First 6 programs for you for the first lab internals. Okay. So now we start with next program. So the program which you have in the last classes, you have seen about 7 programs. So now we start with next one, that is 8th program. So what the 8th program says to you is, so what is the question they have given in your syllabus is, you have to write a Java program to create enumeration day of a week. So what is enumeration? Can anyone say what is enumeration? Akrut, can you say what is enumeration? Yes. Akrut, can you say what is enumeration?
Ma'am, one second.
A list of constants, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, correct, correct, Kaushik. See, what is this enumeration is list of constants. Now, what they want us to create enumeration is they are asking in the program to create enumeration for days of a week. How many days we have in a week? How many days we have in a week?
Seven.
What are they? What are they?
Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Yes, so that's what we have to do in the program. So they have told us, so in the program they have told write a Java program to create an enumeration day of a week. So in this day of a week, what we know with 7 values. And they have told what value should be there. They told that it should be Sunday, Sunday, through Saturday. Till Saturday you should have. Yes, so Sunday to oh, Sunday through Saturday you have to have. And you have to add methods. What methods that you have to add? You have to check whether is it working day or it is a day of the week. So is it a working day? When do you say it is a day of a week? When do you call it is a working day? When do you call it is a working day?
Monday to Friday.
Monday to Friday. When do you say day off? When is off?
Saturday, Sunday.
Yes.
Saturday, Sunday.
That's what we have to do here. We have to check them. And they have told that first we have to create an enumeration and days of a week. So from where to where, Sunday to Saturday, all the days we have to write in the enumeration. And two methods we have to create, that is working day. So we have to check whether if I say today is Tuesday, whether it is a working or not, we have to say that. That is that you have to do it in a is working day. And whether it is a off or not, so that we have to do it in this class that returns true if the value of which it is called Monday through Friday. For example, the day of week, that is Sunday. So then we call it as a, it should say it is a false. So first we see here enumeration. So what is enumeration? So the short form or a keyword we use it as enum. And what is the name we are giving here for the enumeration? We have given day. So you can give anything, but here we have given it as a day. So again, we are saying Sunday. Sunday is 0, Monday is 1, Tuesday is 2, Wednesday is 3, Thursday is 4, Friday is 5, Saturday is 6. So like this, we are giving a list of constants. So you can see when I say pi, so definitely we'll get in our mind 3.142. That we cannot change. Yes, in the same way, here also for the list of constants. I want to make all these list as a constant. That is Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, all these I want to make it as fixed. I don't want to change. So in that case, we use a enumeration day. So Sunday to Saturday, we have to write. So that's what they have told. 7 values, that is Sunday to through Saturday. So Sunday is 0, Monday is 1, 2, Tuesday, 3, Wednesday, Thursday 4, Friday 5, and Saturday 6. So that's what they have given in the question. So now we have created an enumeration. And what is the name of the enumeration? Day. Okay. Now we are taking that day as D. So what is the data type we are taking? We are taking it as an integer, and we are making the access specifier as private. Okay. Then we are calling that enumeration here. So that's what we have created here, enumeration as day. So we are calling this enumeration, and we are saying we don't want to further inherit. So we are making it as a final. Then int this data day we are variable d here we are taking in this enumeration d, and we are assigning current. Current because it every day it keeps changing. Today is Tuesday, so tomorrow it is Wednesday, so day after tomorrow it is Thursday. Means what is a current day? So you can see in your calendar also. So if I click on this calendar, it will, today is, you can see here green color one. What it says? So today is 17th August. So tomorrow this green color will shift to 18th tomorrow. So like this we have to check. So for that we are using the this dot d. So what is the work of this? Can anyone say what is the work of this? Can anyone say what is the work of this? Yes, anybody? What is the use of this? What is it this is doing? Okay.
This is to refer the current method.
Yes. So what is a current thing that should be present? That's what here I just showed you. So here, this is your calendar. In this, what is current? Current day. Current day is Tuesday 17th. So like that, to make that changes, we are using the this dot d equals to d. We are assigning that day to this dot day. Okay. So then we are taking, they have told us to take a working day. So they told us to check method is working day or it is not working day. So in that case, we have taken working day, and we say if d equals to 0, so this d. So what is 0 stands for? What is 0 is? Can anyone say what is this d equals to 0? Yeah, what is d equals to 0? So here in this enumeration, you can see we have made Sunday is 0. So the rest of the other days we have value. So if Sunday, we are just taking here because we are working college for even Saturday also we are working, right? So here we are just making Sunday as off. So in that case, if D is equals to 0, then it should return 0. Else, it has to return whichever day it is. It may be Monday, it may be Friday, it may be Tuesday, whatever it is, it has to return that. So that's what here we are checking for, whether it is a working day or it is not a working day. When we say it is a working, Monday to Saturday, we call it as a working. Only Sunday, we are calling it as a not working. So that's what this method we are checking. Okay, so that's about enumeration and a method, whether it is working or not. Now come back, we are creating a week. So class, we are creating a class and we are calling some name. So here we are calling it as a name, calling a class with some name, that is week. So then any program, any Java program, you should have this line. That's what I keep stressing you. Public, static, void, main, string arguments. What is public? Public, it is accessible to everyone. So what is static? Only one copy of main will be there. We may not create two or three copies of main. Only one copy will be there. A void, the main is not returning anything. Main, where the execution of the program starts. And string. So Java programs, generally we term it in the form of strings. Then arguments. So whenever we want to pass values at the runtime, then we use our arguments. So that's about this level. Okay, then we start, we say d equals to day dot day. That's what we are taking here. Day is what? Day is our enumeration. Day is enumeration. In that enumeration, so what we are doing? Dot Friday dot working day. So we are calling a method working day. We are just assigning some value. So then int d equals to 0. D is 0 means what? It is not working. Other than that, we are saying it is working. That's about your program. So let me take this program to execute and show you. Let me execute this program. What do you expect here? What is your expected output? Yes, what is the expected output? It is working. Why it is saying it is working day? Can anyone say why we are getting the output as it is working day? Anyone? Yes, can anyone say why it is saying it is working day? Why you are getting output as it is working day? Yes, correct. So here in this class we are passing it as a Friday. Okay, let me change it. I will change it to Sunday. Can I do? Yes. So now what should be my output? What should be my output?
It's not a working day.
Yeah. It's not a working day. So like this we change. So what is the work of this program is just to know how this enumeration should be used. Yes, what is enumeration? Enumeration is a list of constants, list of constants. So you can make anything like this. Can I change Sunday, today is Tuesday. Can I make today Tuesday as a Sunday? Can I change? Can I change something like that? It is not possible, right? It is also a universal constant, but what we are doing, this is 1 week. In 1 week, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, like this we call. So that we are making it as an enumeration and we are calling it as a day. Any doubt in this? Any doubt in this program, you can ask. Any doubt in this program, you can ask me. Anybody? Any doubt in this program? Okay. Hoping that you people have understood this program. So let me move on to the next program. It is working day because I have changed it to Wednesday. Any doubt? Any doubt in this program? Hope so it is clear. So the purpose of this program is to just to know you how to use an enumeration. What is enumeration? Enumeration is a list of constants. What constants we can take? Again, it's left to us what is our application program. So in this program, they have told you take a enumeration for days of a week. So what is days of a week we have? What is the days of a week we have? We know it is a Sunday to Monday, Tuesday, all those. So that we have to take. So they've given in, they've specified in our program itself. And again, in that we have to check whether it is a working day or whether it is not a working day. Whether it is a working day or it is not a working day, that's what we have to check here. So that is a working of this program. Anything? Any doubts? Any doubts in this, you can please ask me.
Ma'am?
Yes, yes.
Ma'am, the numbers change madadre output barutalva days to Sunday bande.
Sunday to Monday, ಏನ್ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ
ಮ್ಯಾಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಇದೆಯಲ್ಲ ಚೇಂಜ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೆ ಔಟ್ಪುಟ್ ಬರುತ್ತಲ್ವಾ
ಆ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಬಟ್ ಏನಾಗುತ್ತೆ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ ಅವ್ರು ಸ್ಪೆಸಿಫೈ ಮಾಡಿದಾರಲ್ವಾ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಅವ್ರು ಹೇಳ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದ್ದಾರೆ ಏನ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಸೊ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟೋಲ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಸೆವೆನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಪ್ರೋಗ್ರಾಮ್ ಇಟ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿ ದೇ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಟೇಕ್ ಸೆವೆನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಸೆವೆನ್ ವ್ಯಾಲ್ಯೂಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಶುಡ್ ಬಿ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ They have told that also. They have told that Sunday should be first and Saturday should be last. Yes, got it?
Okay.
So here they mentioned. Yeah, you can change. It is not, we don't want to fix it. But in our requirement, what is the requirement they have given to us? They have told that you take days of a week and there should be 7 values. In that 7 values, which should be first one and which should be last one? So Sunday should be first, Saturday should be last. And in between, we already know that is fixed. We can't change them. So that's how 0, 1, 2, we are fixing. Yes, fine. Okay, so that's about your program. So next program is stack. So can anyone say what is a stack? You have studied somewhere?
In data structures, ma'am. Type of data structure.
Yeah, you have studied in your data structure. What is the stack?
So linear data structure stores elements in a casting cluster.
Okay. So whichever element enters to the stack first will be the element to come out at the last. So whichever one moves first, that will be the last element to come out. That is what a stack. Stack means one end is closed. So because one end is closed, whichever is in the top, that you will be removing first. So that's about the stack, which you have studied in your data structure, and you have even written an exam also. Okay. So what is a question they are giving us? What is a they've told in your question is write a Java program which has what should be the first one? Interface class for a stack operation. What they're saying, they're told that you have to use an interface. Again, in that interface, you have to use what are the operations in the stack? What are the operations in the stack we do?
Push, pop, display.
Yes, and so what is push is doing? Push means
inserting an item into a stack.
Yes, inserting the data or elements into the stack. What is a pop? Yes. So deleting the elements from the stack. Display, how many elements we have in the stack that we are displaying. These are the operation which you already know. So that's what we have to do in this interface. So then now you should say me, what is interface? What is interface?
Interface is a collection of abstract methods and Python variables.
So in interface, we are not doing any implementation. We can't do implementation. So that is what is in interface. Okay. So that is about first one. Second one, what they're saying is a class that implements the stack interface. We have already created an interface for a stack that we have to use in one class. And what we have to do? Fixed length stack. So what do we mean by fixed length? What is a fixed length stack? So now I'm saying I can insert only 5 elements. I'm fixing. I'm not increasing to 7th elements. In case if I insert only 5 elements, if I start inserting one more element, 6th element, what it should do, what it should say to me, stack is full. Yes. So that is what is called as a fixed. Okay. So now sometime, can you give some example of a fixed in your data structure, which is a fixed one? Somewhere where you are fixing array, are you fixing or you are not fixing? Array of size 10, is it fixed or it is not fixed?
Fixed, ma'am. It's fixed.
Yeah, it is fixed. Okay, can you give? Okay, that's about a fixed. Same way, one more thing what they are saying is a class that implements stack, again use the same stack interface, but in this case dynamic length stack. Dynamic means what? What do you mean by dynamic? What is fixed and what is dynamic?
Dynamic means we are giving the size in a runtime. Correct.
Yes, correct. So what we are doing, sometimes I don't know what may be memory allocation, what I require to allocate memory. I don't know that initially only. I may know once I complete my project. So in that case, we use something called as a dynamic. So what do we mean by dynamic is at the runtime, I will allocate memory for these many things. Yes. So now what we are doing, once you come for your exam, lab exam, we will be fixing. So 10 students each day. And which 10 students each day, we are fixing them. So this B1 batch, 8:30 to 11:30. So 11:30 to, so like this, we are fixing. That is an example for fixed. So sometimes what we do is, now we have told everything, anything. Sometimes we may say surprise quiz. Then we are not fixing anything. We give it on the same day. That is an example for dynamic. So I can do your quiz at any time. That is what a dynamic length stack means. I am not fixing any length of the stack. So that I have to do it in a one more class. And one more class I have to use, a class that uses both above stacks through interface reference and does the stack operations. So this we have to do the demonstration. That demonstrate the runtime binding. So this is just an extra thing. So this is about the stack operation. So this we have to do. Okay. First one, what? Interface. Interface is what? So you can see, when we say interface, we use a interface keyword. Give anything, any name you give. Here we have given it as a some int stack. Yes. So, and what are the operations we are doing in int? You told push operation we are doing and pop operation we are doing. So what is push? Push is inserting element into the stack. So that's the reason what element we are taking it as an item. And how the item we are doing, what type of item it is? It is a integer. Means what? I can insert only 10, 20, 0, 1, 2. So integers I am inserting into what is a stack, my stack name. Int stack is the interface. These are the two methods what I have in the interface. That is push, inserting element, pop, taking out the element from the stack. So this is what is called as an interface. Okay. So this we have done. This first one is done. What is first one says? Interface class for stack operation. So we have done interface. What are the operation? Push, pop. Okay. Next one, you come to class that implements stack interface and create fixed length stack. Okay, now already we have done with interface. Now we have to create a class. What class we have to create? Fixed length. So just we have taken it as a F stack. F stacks says to us it is a fixed stack. Fixed stack means what? Memory is fixed. And why do we use implements? Why should we use implements? Why not extends? Yes, can anyone say why should I use implements? Why not extends keyword?
Implement user to implement the interface.
Okay, correct.
So the class.
Yes, yes, correct. So what we are doing here is, because it is an interface, I have to use implement. In place of interface, if I have a class, then I would have used a extends. Getting? So that's what here implements. What I want to implement this interface. What is the interface name? Int stack. Okay. Okay. So now we are, what they have told, fixed size. So I'm making the size of my stack fixed. So I'm just saying, what is a stack data type? It is of integer. Integer what? Why? Because here I have told items, what I want to insert into the stack is of type integer. Okay. So then top. So we know the element what I want to take, we are generally call it as a top. Then what we have told, size should be fixed. So for fixing, we are calling it as a, what is this we are calling? Can anyone say what is this? What is this? F stack int size is what?
It's constructor.
Correct. Correct. So what is this F stack size? It is a constructor. When do we say it is a constructor? Whenever I have my class name same as a method, then we call it as a constructor. Okay. So F stack, we are using the constructor and we are saying what should be the size. So here I am saying creating ST. So here already I have ST, but here I am not used size because I have to say it is a fixed size. So that's what here new. So int size. So then initially I'm saying top equals to minus one. So this is my constructor and the size I am fixing. Okay. So then public. So I have to do operations, right? Push and pop. So push operation before that, I have to check whether there is a space to insert any elements into the stack. So that's what we are doing. We are checking here whether the top length, if it is full, then I say it is stack is overflow. Else, if it is not full, if it still there is a space to insert, then we are inserting item. Then display. So this method is for pushing, means inserting element into the stack. Okay, after inserting, I have to do pop operation. So I'm doing a pop operation here. Yes. So again, in pop, in case if I don't have elements in the stack, and if I start deleting, can we delete? It is not possible. Then that is what is called as a stack underflow. Elements e illa, but matte delete madondre hengagutte agala. So that is what is called as a underflow. So you will be knowing, you would have studied in data structure, when we call it as underflow, when we call it as a overflow. Overflow means like your syntax, water filling on your top of the house. If syntax is full, the water will be flowed out. That is overflow. Underflow, so in your down pump, in your sump, there is no water, but still you are pumping. So then that is what is called as a underflow. Same way here, overflow and underflow. So that's what here, push is for inserting, pop is for deleting. So we have done that. So that's what here, this is just for checking whether stack is, any elements are there for deleting or not. If elements are there, I have to delete them. So we are deleting. So this is what is called as a class for fixed size of a stack. So this part, this class, what we have done, this is for a fixed class. Second part of our question is done. This is done. They have told fixed stack. Now we move on to the dynamic length stack. That's our next one. Okay, so here you can see D stack. Just to, you can give any name. To make it difference, we have just given D stack. So dynamic stack, and we have to use interface. That's what the question says to us. The interface. So interface name, we have given it as a int stack, and that we are taking into a dynamic stack. So stack is initialized top, and we are saying stack size. So dynamic stack, again, you can see this is a constructor. So initializing the size, then inserting, pushing the elements. Here you can see, again, we are creating a stack, temporary memory allocation to check what is the size. Yes, so st dot length of the size. What is the size of this st? So what is st here? St is what? St is this one. You can see here. This is what st is. So that we are doing it in a pop, pushing the elements. So then, till where I have to push? Because it is dynamic. How many? What is the length? How much length I have, so much I can insert. So that's what here you can see for loop. So how many elements I want, I can do, keep repeating. So that's what here we are taking one temporary thing, whatever is there, move that to a st. Temporary, one temporary memory we want, because we don't know, it is not fixed. I may first say one element. Next time I may say two element. Next time I may say three elements. So like this, I can insert any number. So that's the reason we are taking a temporary and store back into the stack. So that's what here we are doing. And increment and item to be pushed and display the item. So this is about inserting elements into the dynamic stack. So next, pop. Same way how we have done the pop, deleting the element. So that's what here, this one, just check whether elements are there. If it is not there, then stack underflow. If it is there, elements, then delete. That's what here we have done. Delete and display what element we are deleting. So that's about here. Dynamic size. Last one, we have to just demonstrate all these. So we are using class public static void main for any Java program. One is compulsory, main should be there. Then they have told reference. You have to use a stack reference. And we are creating an object for fixed stack, and we are creating an object for dynamic stack and reference interface. And how many times you want to repeat? How many times you want to use a reference and insert a push, insert an element, or how many elements you want to pop using a reference. So that's about a one stack fixed size. So again here I'm changing dynamic stack. So for that, this one. This is about your stack. Okay, so what is your expected output? Yes, you can see here stack is first one, fixed stack is 10, dynamic stack we have made it as 12, but again still we can change it. So that's what here it is keep displaying. So 10, so then stack overflow, delete the stack underflow if it is deleted. Again items, how many items? It's because 0 to 11. So that's what here 12, then pop all the elements. That's about here. For this one, one time we are doing. This is for fixed stack. So that's what here you can see FS. FS is what? Fixed. DS is what? Dynamic. So that's what here you can see. This is fixed stack. This is dynamic stack object. Call that object using a reference. So again, reference, what we have told, you have to use a interface. So that's what your reference. Call that reference. Call the fixed stack size, insert and delete, push and pop. In the same way, insert, use a reference type for dynamic stack, push and pop. Any doubt? So here, because we have told 10, so you can see till 9 is there, push the element and pop the element, how many? 9. Here, how many we have? 12. So that's what here you can see, 12 for this part. Then delete. Delete all the items. Okay. Any doubt regarding this program? Any doubt? So this completes your 8 and 9 program. Left with only two more programs. Yes, so the last two programs, that I'll cover it in the next lab, and that will be end of your lab, such lab from my end. That is Java 10 and 11. So 9th I have done, 10th and 11th program I have to do it. What are the syllabus, your lab program? So we have done with constructor overloaded and method overloading. So we have done with inner class, string, Java string, inheritance, balance. So where we have used for the account and consumer, producer and consumer, then package we have done. Today we have done with enumeration and stack. And the last one will be input-output string, input-output files. And the last one is linked list class. So that will be end of your lab programs. Today's date is 17/8. Answer your attendance, Anaga.
Yes, ma'am.
Abhilash.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Akhil.
Yes, ma'am.
Akrut.
Yes, ma'am.
Akshay. Anusha.
Yes, ma'am.
Arvind. Arifullah.
Yes, ma'am.
Danaka.
Present, ma'am.
Panu Prakash. Panu Prakash.
Yes, ma'am.
Bhargav.
Yes, ma'am.
Rehmatullah.
Present, ma'am.
Panu Prakash is present. Banu Prakash.
Yes, ma'am. Present.
Yes, ma'am. Present. Bhargav.
Yes, ma'am.
Chaitra.
Present, ma'am.
Chandana. Chandana. Charan.
Yes, ma'am.
Darshan.
Present, ma'am.
Deeksha. Deeksha. Dakshayani.
Present, ma'am.
Kishan.
Present, ma'am.
Harshit. Harshit. Emilata.
Present, ma'am.
Uma.
Present, ma'am.
Jayant. Jayant. Divya. Divya.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Present, ma'am.
Kaushik.
Present, ma'am. Kaushik.
Lakshmi.
Present, ma'am.
Lavanya. Yes, Kaushik Mad. Lavanya.
Present, ma'am.
Manish.
Present, ma'am.
The last lab, I don't know which, when was the date was on 7th. Last lab, you were absent, sir. 7-7. Manish. Okay,
ma'am.
Manoj.
Yes, ma'am.
Mohit.
Yes, ma'am.
Naval. Yes, ma'am. Navya. Navya. Nikhil.
Present, ma'am.
Panindra.
Ma'am.
Pavan. Pavan. Pooja.
Present, ma'am.
Purnima. Purnima. Raman.
Present, ma'am.
Rashmi.
Present, ma'am.
Rupak.
Yes, ma'am.
Sai Kumar.
Present, ma'am.
Sameer.
Present, ma'am.
Santosh. Santosh.
Present, ma'am.
Sadab.
Present, ma'am.
Sharan. Charan. Chashank.
Present, ma'am.
Chashank. Cheetal. Cheetal. Shivani.
Present, ma'am.
Soumyashree.
Present, ma'am.
Spurti. Spurti.
Present, ma'am.
Sri Vishnu. Sugandini.
Present, ma'am.
Sushma. Sushma.
Present, ma'am.
Present,
Sushmita.
Present, ma'am.
Sushmita, you.
Present, ma'am.
Teerta.
Present, ma'am.
Trupti.
Present, ma'am.
Varsha.
Present, ma'am.
Veena.
Present, ma'am.
Sri Vishnu is present.
What?
Huh? Sri Vishnu. Shashank.
Ma'am, Pavan present, ma'am.
Sheetal, Pavan present. Yes,
ma'am. Present, ma'am.
Navya.
No. Jayant, ma'am, present. Network issue ide, ma'am. Navya.
Chandana. Purnima marked. Arvind. Chandana. Deeksha. Harshit. Shashank. Sheetal. Sri Vishnu.
Ma'am, Sheetal present.
Huh? What happened?
Sheetal present, ma'am.
Sheetal. Sheetal present. Okay.
So we'll stop here and continue in the next lab. Hope so, next lab should be our last lab.